championships, the story of the U.S. women's gymnastics team at the Pan American Games has its place. And women's gymnastics has been part of the game since 1959, and at every single edition of the games, bar two of them in 1979 and 1999, the U.S. women have taken the gold medal. And here are the five individuals who are trying to extend that legacy here today.
Kayla DiCello. Zoe Miller.
The women of Team USA, Zoe Miller, Tiana Sumana Sequeira, Jordan Childs, Kalia Lincoln, and Kayla DiCello. The United States is going to begin on balance beam.
Costa Rica, Venezuela, Peru.
Grupo Mixto 3.
The first of two mixed groups in this second subdivision. Francini Morales of Costa Rica.
Venezuela. Deborah
also from Costa Rica, Ana Elena Rodriguez.
Peru, Ana Karina Mendez.
Venezuela, Deborah Salmina, joined by Ana Karina Mendez of Peru. This group will begin on the uneven bars.
Haiti, Dominican Republic, and Barbados.
Grupo Mixto 2.
Lindsey Brown of Haiti will start off on the uneven bars. Camille Betances of the Dominican Republic. She is joined by her teammate, and from Barbados, Anya Pilgrim. Ana Fuentes, the other Dominican gymnast in this subdivision.
Argentina.
Argentina, the silver medal winning team at the South American Championships last year.
Lucila Estarli.
Lucila Estarli, the 29-year-old veteran of the team. Nicole Iribarne, just 16 years old. Milagros Corti Ruiz, a 17-year-old. Melina Mesropian, the 18-year-old.
Leila Martinez.
And finally, Leila Martinez, an 18-year-old from Buenos Aires, the niece of a professional footballer who played in Argentina and France. Argentina won the bronze medal at the Pan American Games back in 1995. It is their only team medal at this competition. Team per apparatus. The slight exception to that is the uneven bars, where warm-ups tend to take a little bit longer because some gymnasts like to chalk the bars a different way. And here is the gymnast who will go first for the United States, Kalia Lincoln. A gymnast tabbed as an emerging star.
In this rotation,
a great hope
starting
for the future.
Argentina.
And on bars, Haitian Lindsey Brown takes to the apparatus.
On uneven bars, mixed group two, Haiti, Dominican Republic, and Barbados.
En barras asimétricas, grupo mixto dos, Haiti, República Dominicana, y Barbados.
Tiana Sumana Sequeira, the 16-year-old,
on balance
will be up
beam,
second for the U.S.
States
on beam.
Of America.
En viga, Estados Unidos de América.
Third will be Jordan Childs, the Olympic team silver medalist from Tokyo.
Venezuela and Peru.
On the uneven bars, Lindsey Brown, followed by Camille Batanchas, Ana Fuentes, and Anya Pilgrim of Barbados. Anya Pilgrim, another gymnast who made her debut at the World Championships in Antwerp last month, rather earlier this month. Already feels like some time ago, even though it has been really no time at all. Here, one of the world stars of 2021, the third strongest all-arounder at the World Championships in Kitakyushu, Japan, Kayla DiCello, a gymnast who at one point was iffy about continuing her elite career, did a year with the team at the University of Florida and decided that she had more in her, that there was more she wanted to accomplish. And here she is. Hello, Team USA. We will not be seeing on the balance beam Zoe Miller, who is an absolute standout on the uneven bars. Miller and Tiana Sumana-Sekera trained together in Texas along with Jordan Childs at World Championship Center.
That completes the warm-up period. Judges, please call your first competitor.
Ha finalizado el tiempo de calentamiento. Damos inicio a la competencia.
On balance beam for the United States of America, Kalia Lincoln. Setting up for a double turn in the Cossack or sit position, one leg extended. Routine from the 17-year-old who is still rather inexperienced at the senior international level. Yeah, she got it. Lincoln is a gymnast who drew a lot of attention for her performance at the U.S. Championships this year. She won the silver medal on floor exercise there. And she was the gold medalist on floor exercise at the Winter Cup competition. Well performed throughout. And this diver-like double pike to a near perfect landing. That was just beautiful. Routine one of her Pan American Games has gone very well indeed. Plenty of reason to smile for Kalia Lincoln. completion of her score. And up on the podium, Tiana Sumana Sekera, who turned 16 just last month, waits to go on balance beam. Sumana Sekera is the reigning Pan Am champion in the all-around. That's a very good number for Kalia Lincoln to start with. And now Tiana Sumana Sekera will attempt to build on the 13 scored by her teammate. Her mount is a candle, as it's colloquially known, a back dive to chest stand. And this is a special sequence. Backhand spring to 2 feet, and layout to 2 feet. Wonderful. Switch ring to ring jump. Position that can be very difficult to hit for credit. She's still very young, but what's been clear in the international outings that she's had so far is that there is a real knack for balance beam. Waiting to perform on the uneven bars, Camille Betances of the Dominican Republic, a 19-year-old from Santo Domingo. Let's take another look at the work of Tiana Sumana Sekera on the balance beam. From an aerial standpoint, you see how precise a gymnast has to be in order to do those elements. A flight series is required, and yet few gymnasts choose to do the series, taking the risk that she does. Betances on the uneven bars. And now from Haiti, here is Lindsay Brown with her first routine at her debut Pan American Games. Good Stalder to Maloney to pack salto combination. It's very clean on this apparatus. The Van Leeuwen transition. And a double layout dismount. She's got it. From a difficulty standpoint, this routine does not score very highly, but from an execution standpoint, she does everything she possibly can to get herself near the 10 points that are available for execution. Wonderful double layout. Gorgeous in the air, extended body position, pointed toes, and a really secure landing. 11.066, the number for Lindsay Brown. Note the difficulty, 3.2. We will see higher than that, but the execution is what makes it. Waiting to begin on the balance beam, Jordan Chiles. Tiana Sumana-Sekera, currently ranked sixth in the nation on this apparatus. Here is Camille Betances of the Dominican Republic on uneven bars. Solid routine so far. And a double pike dismount, good and high. Camille Batan says his competition is underway. Let's take another look at it. Transition to the low bar, unusual in this era. And she finishes off with a nice high double pike dismount, well above the high bar. Looks for the landing and plants her feet. 10.533 the score for Camille Betances of the Dominican Republic. A gymnast who has become a fixture at Pan American Continental events. Over on the balance beam, Jordan Chiles has had a long wait to compete. So long that she's actually taken a seat at the edge of the mat, perfectly allowed. And Sumana-Sekera is still waiting for her score. Early in the last subdivision as well, there was some delay in the scoring on balance beam. Jordan Chiles is taking it all in. She's ready. The judges, it seems, are not. Now, Ana Fuentes of the Dominican Republic. She has actually fallen from the uneven bars and is being lifted back up by her coach. Moves smoothly into a pack salto, however. Struggles with her kip handstand following the transition. And opts just for a simple layout flyaway dismount. This is her second major international competition in 2 years, having competed at the Pan American Championships in 2022. Gymnasts should be trying to hit the 12 o'clock position, a complete vertical in their handstands on uneven bars. And with her final one before her giants into her dismount, she didn't get there. That will be a deduction, and 8.666 is her score. Jordan Chiles has now come down from the podium. The U.S. team might be aware that there is some delay in the scoring. Tiana Sumana-Secker's number has still not come up. And here now on uneven bars, Anya Pilgrim of Barbados. Steady Stalderful to Maloney to Pack Salto. Very good indeed. And a close, careful half turn. She's clipped the low bar with her foot, but still manages to do her double tuck dismount. When a gymnast hits the bar with her foot, that does carry a fairly significant deduction. And it's something that doesn't always break their swing, but you hear it, and so you know it's happened. The toe circle standing on the bar, and then reaching for the high bar, her transition. And 9-9, the score for Anya Pilgrim of Barbados on the uneven bars. Over on the balance beam, Jordan Chiles is still waiting to compete. Only two of the four Americans have been able to go so far. Kayla DiCello will compete fourth. Meanwhile, Zoe Miller is simply chilling out. And why not? She is not doing beam here. Olympian Cécile Landy, who competed for France, and now an integral part of the U.S. national team coaching squad. Unfortunately, with this delay, all the Americans can do is stay loose, complete their warm-ups, continue to warm up, and wait for the signal to be able to resume. But obviously, this is a very cool team. Greets the 13.066 score of Tiana Sumana-Secker. It is led by Jordan Chiles, who will take to the balance beam in just a moment. Some gymnasts might become tense or nervous by facing such a long delay. But Jordan Chiles of the United States is one cool customer. Here she is on the beam at last. Her first big test will be this acrobatic series. Back handspring layout, handled with very minimal problem. Front aerial straddle jump to back handspring. apparatus is a style of gymnastics that really combines energy, grace, and finesse. And she's really honed that at the University of California, Los Angeles, where she's competed for the last 2 years. So far, this has been very nice. Dismount, double pike. Jordan Childs of the United States gives a masterclass of coolness under pressure. The long wait didn't affect her at all in that routine. And the United States is once again on track. 3 up, 3 hit for Team USA. On the apparatus that many gymnasts consider to be among the most perilous. No problem for Jordan Childs. The side aerial was just wonderful. And there's a switch side leap. Her technique on this double pike dismount is so good. Just the tiniest of hops. Up on the podium now is Kayla DiCello, waiting for her turn to compete. DiCello coming off of her freshman season at the University of Florida, where she is one of the stars of their team. The score for Jordan Childs on the balance beam, 13.0. So the United States, all in the neighborhood of 13.0, 13.1, 13.2, they have been very consistent. And now for Team USA, Kayla DiCello on balance beam. She'll start with the same mount that we saw from Tiana Sumanasekera, the candle. And yes, before you do it, you always glance back to make sure that the balance beam is still there. Very nice triple Cossack turn. The skill named for Lauren Mitchell of Australia, who competed it about 15 years ago. It's vintage Kayla DiCello on balance beam. A steady back handspring, layout, step out combination. Consistency on balance beam particularly has always marked her gymnastics, and that's clearly intact. Double pike, a bit compressed as she hit the mat, hence the large step forward, but overall a successful exercise for Kayla DiCello. She shares a hug with her longtime coach, Kelly Hill. So So four up, four hit for the United States of America. Here's another look at the complicated Cossack turn. And this was the dismount. She casts her body backwards a bit rather than upwards out of her round off. And as a result, doesn't quite get the height that she needs to go for a really good landing on the double pike. But apart from that, the routine was excellent. Zoe Miller has everyone's backpacks. A little pre-competition conditioning, perhaps. .066 is Kayla DiCello's score on balance beam. And with that, rotation one of four comes to a close in Subdivision 2 at the Pan American Games. Now, the classified results thus far show Mexico in the lead. That is, of course, because Mexico has completed its four apparatus competition. The United States currently in fourth place, but that score on balance beam, the team score, 39.365, is the best team score on balance beam by just about 3 points. They have 3 points on Mexico on this apparatus. Argentina has scored 38.365 on vault. That is the third best that we have seen of the teams that have already competed. Still to come in Subdivision 3, Brazil, Canada, Chile, and Puerto Rico. There are no individuals in the next subdivision. It will be a straight team competition. The United States moves to floor in the second rotation, where we will see the same four who competed on balance beam. Tiana Sumana-Sekera, Jordan Childs, Kayla DiCello, and Kelly Lincoln. Zoe Miller will be a factor on the uneven bars.
On balance beam, Dominican Republic, Barbados, and Haiti.
And just to give you an update of where we stand in the individual apparatus competition, from Subdivision 1, the top score on vault came from Atsiri Sandoval of Mexico. Caitlin Jong, who is competing for the U.S. as an individual and is not part of the team competition here, recorded the best number on bars, 13.633. And currently, the top four scores on balance beam all belong to gymnasts from the United States. Kalia Lincoln, the Pan American Games debutante, leading the way with 13.233. And on floor exercise, Panama's Hillary Heron, who really brought the house down with her tumbling and her exuberance, scored 12.966. That is the best that we have seen thus far on floor. Argentina moves over to the uneven bars, the U.S. on floor exercise, mixed groups on vault and balance beam.
The
gymnast that completes the warm-up period. Judges, please call your first competitor.
Ha finalizado el tiempo de calentamiento. Damos inicio a la competencia.
Beginning on floor exercise for the United States, the 16-year-old Tiana Sumanasekara. Sit back and be enchanted. Tiana Sumanasekara of the United States in her Pan American Games debut on floor exercise. What an exquisitely polished exercise that was. There's not only the dance and her choreography that was great about this routine, but the tumbling is absolutely first class. Double twisting, double tuck to open. She finds the ground well. Her second pass was a double layout. There it is. Slightly short, has to take a step forward, but the body position in the air is just superb. 1.5 twist to a front full in the layout position. And throughout it all, it is infused with a lovely sense of musicality and movement. Sumanasekara, when she was 6 years old, went to a gymnastics-themed birthday party and loved bouncing on the trampolines. And the instructor at the birthday party was actually surprised that she was not already enrolled in gymnastics. She started after that. 13.0, her score on floor. And now, Jordan Childs of the United States on one of her signature apparatus.
Thank you.
The full package on floor exercise. Jordan Childs of the United States. Come for the tumbling, stay to be thoroughly entertained by her dance. This is one of her middle passes, the 1.5 through to a full twisting double tuck. She opened up with a full twisting double layout. Gorgeous in the air. And this her third pass, the front layout walkout through to the double tuck. It actually looked like she had some problems going into her round off, but it didn't really hamper the double salto that was to come. It's very impressive work, and she ends with a double pike. Over on the uneven bars, here is Leila Martinez of Argentina, an 18-year-old from Buenos Aires. She finishes her toe stalder full quite far out of handstand, so she'll receive a slight deduction from that. Her swing, however, is quite fluid. Blind transition to a Jaeger. Dismount coming up, double tap. Leila Martinez of Argentina on the uneven bars. She trains at the Vélez Sarsfield Athletic Club in Buenos Aires and made her World Challenge Cup this year. Her debut, rather, in Paris. Now to Kayla DiCello of the US on floor. Team USA's Kayla DiCello finishing her floor routine. Kayla DiCello, still only 19 years old, but she has accomplished so much already. From her debuts at the first Junior World Championships back in 2019 to making the Olympic team as an alternate in Tokyo 2 years later. And now she is in her university era competing for Florida, though she has taken a gap year to prepare for the Paris Olympics and her run at it. And one thing that she's really developed in the NCAA has been a real maturity of movement and a style that is continuously evolving, well presented in this routine. And Now, Milagros Curti Ruiz of Argentina takes to the uneven bars. And she catches the bail, the transition to low bar, with quite bent elbows, which impacts her swing. She'll also receive a deduction for the rhythm and just the incorrect technique of that transition. However, she has gotten her swing back. The pirouettes are good. Giants in a double pike dismount. One step forward. 11.2, the score for Milagros Curti Ruiz. And now, Kalia Lincoln of the United States on her signature apparatus, the floor exercise. What she has that people around the world are marveling at is an acceleration into her tumbling that is almost second to none. Kalia Lincoln of the United States continuing to blaze her trail on the international stage. This is the apparatus where she really first drew notice. Good position in the Cossack turn, but it is on the tumbling where she is phenomenal. Full twisting, double layout. Unfortunately, she does bounce out of bounds with both feet. There will be a 3/10 penalty to her score as a result. Here's another look at the front layout, full walk out to round off back handspring, double tuck. No question, she is a rising star. Nicole Iribarn of Argentina on the uneven bars. Jaeger and Pack Salto transition. And she wanted, I think, to do a handstand half turn. There it is. And instead she does an improvised clear hip circle, but with very good form. Out of handstand, however, on the finish of her full pirouette and a double pike dismount. She fought through that well. She was able to deal with the fact that not everything went as planned. And I believe, actually, we are looking at a replay of the exercise of Lucila Astarli of Argentina, the 29-year-old super veteran. And and the national champion on vault from 2022. There we are. Lucila Estarli of Argentina, 11.1 her score on the uneven bars. Kalia Lincoln, meanwhile, draws in a huge 13.8 on floor exercise. The classified results of all teams at this point in the competition. The United States currently in fourth place, leading Argentina, the two teams presently competing in this subdivision, by a margin of about 6.5 points. Mexico has posted the number to beat, just in excess of 150 points. And they did that in subdivision one earlier today. So, floor done. On to vault for Team USA. Lucila Estarli of Argentina and her teammates will move to the balance beam. And the two mixed groups will be on uneven bars and floor exercise. As they move towards their third apparatus, the United States plainly on course for a very good finish at this Pan American Games. Halfway through, they have not recorded a major error in any routine. And this is with a competition format that allows teams to drop their weakest score on every apparatus. The top score for Team USA on floor exercise came from Kalia Lincoln, just as it did on balance beam. She is having a fabulous debut performance at the Pan American Games thus far. And that 13.8 on floor exercise stands as the highest score that has been recorded on the apparatus thus far. Here's a look at what the USA will present on vault. It will be Kayla DiCello leading off, followed by Lincoln Simana Sekera and Jordan Childs, the silver medalist at the World Championships on this apparatus in 2022, to finish them off. Over on the balance beam, Nicole Iribane will get things started for Argentina, followed by Milagros Curti Ruiz, the newcomer Leila Martinez, and the veteran, Lucila Estarli, to round off the effort.
And on floor exercise, mixed group two, Dominican Republic, Barbados, and Haiti.
Y el suelo, grupo mixto dos, República Dominicana, Barbados, y Haiti.
The United States warming up on vault. Jordan Childs will be showing a double twisting Yurchenko. And what power. But But also, what finesse in that piece of gymnastics. Here's the warm-up of Kayla DiCello. She has very steady double twisting Yurchenko of her own. Kaylee Lincoln is in the middle of a breakout performance. She too will do a double twisting Yurchenko. The gymnast who has posted the two highest scores for the United States so far is the one with the least experience. Tiana Sumana-Sekera shows her double twisting Yurchenko in warm-up. The protocol dictates that all gymnasts can touch the vault twice during this warm-up, which is colloquially known, ironically, as a one-touch, but they can have three if they are doing two vaults. And Jordan Childs is certainly doing that. She's warming up her second vault, the Podkopayeva. Vaulting first for the USA will be Kayla DiCello. What a wonderful double twist in Yurchenko, and what a wonderful start to the US's competition on vault. Oh, that was just poetry in the air, wasn't it? Fantastic absorption of the table, translated in the block into great height, and a very pretty double twist. Kelly Lincoln will go next. Once again, the score for Kayla DiCello is really taking quite some time to be posted. It can't be because of the judges. There really isn't that much to deduct from that double twisting Yurchenko. Let's move over to the balance beam and Milagros Curti Ruiz. her dismount. 1.5 twist, very secure. She did have a fall on her mount. She went for a round off layout step out, but unfortunately incurred an intentional dismount. That, of course, carrying a 1-point deduction. And here is a look at the mount sequence once again. It's very complicated. And if the gymnast is any way off, whether perhaps there's not enough height on her back layout, generally the fall is what results. However, there was some very nice work in this exercise. Her flight series, as well as a mixed series of leaps and acrobatics, and the 1.5 twist dismount. Milagros Corti Ruiz, 17 years old. She competed on balance beam at the World Championships earlier this month, where she finished in the top 50. Meanwhile, over on vault, Kalia Lincoln is still waiting to compete. And if this goes on much longer, it's likely that she will come down off of the podium, just like Jordan Childs did in her delay on the balance beam. Meanwhile, 11.466 the score for the 17-year-old from Argentina. And now her teammate, Leila Martinez, takes to the beam. And she too misses her round off layout step out. What that means is no matter what, Argentina will count at least one fall on the balance beam. As Martinez shows a side aerial to back handspring. The Argentinians are noted for their style, especially on balance beam. And in terms of their world ranking and future prospects, they have two exceptional juniors who competed at the Junior World Championships this year. Dismount for Martinez. Simple but well performed. Layout with a full twist. Have another look at the mount. Slightly different problem for her team from her teammate. She has enough height to go for a good landing on the layout step out, but I think her hips just weren't square to the beam, and neither were her shoulders. And it's a very, very difficult skill to save if those things are not the case. Smooth dismount, round off full twist. And here at last is Kalia Lincoln on vault. big double twisting Yurchenko planned. And a big double twisting Yurchenko delivered. Lincoln, just 17 years old, has not had too much international experience, but she is handling herself like a consummate veteran. This is what you would expect on vault from someone who can tumble the way that she does. And the step back, really the only big issue with this 13.933, her score. And now on balance beam for Argentina, Lucila Estarli. And that was a wonderful popa straddle jump with a full turn. Difficult too. And how secure was that back handspring layout step out combination? Her two appearances at the World Championships came 13 years apart. She competed in Rotterdam in 2010 and then in Antwerp earlier this month. And she says it's crazy to relive a World Championships at the age of 29. She said it was a phenomenal experience and something that she will remember always. And a front layout with full twist is her dismount. Lucila Estarli, still an inspiration to her younger teammates, presenting great routines on the international level. With two of its gymnasts having fallen, Argentina needed something big for her. And when you do that, it is often a veteran who you can turn to. Nice punch front mount, very good back handspring layout step out right on. The experience really shows through. Now the dismount, front layout, full twist, punching off the balance beam and landing on the ground. ...11.933 for Lucila Estarli of Argentina on balance beam. And now Jordan Childs of the USA on vault. This is her second vault, the Podkapayeva. There's a lot happening. The round off onto the board, the half turn onto the table, and the front layout with half twist off. It's a vault that she's performed steadily for several years now, and a big part of why she won the silver medal at the World Championships in 2022 on this apparatus. Look at the extension, and just admire how straight she is able to keep her body. Many gymnasts pike down at the end of it, not Jordan Childs. And she just about keeps herself within the white tram lines. Let's see if there is a penalty. Well, there is. They took a 10th, but hey, 14.099. That is the average that she has gotten. And that is the best score for gymnasts who have done two vaults at this Pan American Games so far. Hellos from Argentina. They will end their competition on floor exercise. The U.S. in just a few moments will move over to the uneven bars. And the mixed groups will go to vault and balance beam. It has been all business for the United States. On the apparatus, in any case, they do look like they're having a bit of pleasure when they are just standing around and waiting to compete. And that's something that's so lovely to see. There is a relaxed ambiance among this team. The standings through three of four rotations of Subdivision 2. The United States coming up on the leaders, Mexico, Colombia, and Panama, the teams that competed in Subdivision 1.
That completes the third rotation. Gymnasts, please proceed now to your fourth and final.
And they have been having such a good competition that the USA needs only something in excess of about 10 points per gymnast on the uneven bars, and they will take the lead from Mexico. So if they can deliver three strong routines, they stand to lead by a good margin, with Subdivision 3 still waiting in the wings. Starting order for Subdivision 4 on the uneven bars for the United States. Meanwhile, on floor exercise, Nicole Iribarn of Argentina will lead the team off, and they will have their veteran, the 29-year-old Lucila Estarli, who is in the anchor spot. Thank you. Leading off for Argentina on floor exercise, Nicole Iribarne, the 16-year-old. Her World Championships debut came earlier this month in Antwerp, where she was 24th with Team Argentina. And now she adds to her already impressive CV a Pan American Games. Nicole Iribarne, just 16 years old. Lovely double turn with leg up to open. The turn is sit position. Takes so much strength to do that. Solid double tuck. Iribarne already being recognized for her accomplishments. She has been awarded the medal for sports merit for artistic gymnastics from her city for 4 of the last 5 years. Now on to the uneven bars, and Tiana Sumana Sekera of the United States. Nice Maloney to Pack Salto. There's the Van Leeuwen transition. Legs come apart ever so slightly on the blind change before her Jaeger. This should be a double layout dismount. No, full twisting double tuck. She has changed things up. Tiana Sumana Sekera completing her qualification competition at these 2023 Pan American Games. She does catch her Jaeger with bent elbows. She'll receive a deduction of a few tenths as a result. She was just a little bit close to the bar. And here, the new dismount, different from what she competed earlier this season, if memory serves. Very good full twisting double tuck. Lovely technique. 12.9 the score for Tiana Sumana Sekera. And let us return to the floor exercise and Milagros Curti Ruiz. Milagros Curti Ruiz of Argentina, finishing her competition on floor exercise. It's an expressive routine, and she's thrilled. Oh, yes. Argentina's last medal at the Pan American Games, its only medal in women's gymnastics, came in 1995, and it was a bronze. And with this new generation, they are daring to dream. Milagros Curti Ruiz, still just 17 years old. And quite obviously full of potential, just like her team. Lovely delivery from her. Teammate Leila Martinez, who is currently performing on floor. And here's a look at that exercise. Leila Martinez of Argentina on floor exercise. Quite a shame about her final tumbling pass on the double twist. It looks like her legs just got crossed under her. Does a nice job of holding her leg at horizontal all the way through her double turn. Shows a double tuck. The score for Leila Martinez, 10.233 on floor. And finally for Argentina, their veteran, the 29-year-old Lucila Estarli. Thank you. the gymnast who works as a sports teacher and competes for her national team, Lucila Estarli, finishing on floor exercise. And if she seems a little rueful in expression, it's probably because of the landing on her final tumbling pass. Let's have another look. This is her first pass. Very nice double layout. Maintaining stretched body position in the air all the way through. Powerful too. And then for her middle pass, she opts to do a simple single front layout. And the final pass, double tuck, good and high. And just a landing where her chest is so close to the floor that it pings her legs up in the air and she goes forward. One cannot fail to touch one's hands to the ground when that happens. The final performance of Jordan Childs of the United States on the uneven bars. Toe Stalder full to Pike Kachev to immediate pack salto. Great form throughout on this combination as well. And then Maloney to immediate Ginger, legs totally glued together. This is very good so far. Good snap on her piked Jaeger. Such a nice variety of elements in this exercise as well. It flows from bar to bar. And there's only the dismount. Full twisting double tuck and a stick from Jordan Childs. Yes. That caps a fabulous day for Jordan Childs and for Team USA. Childs, a gymnast who seemingly has done it all. She's been to the Olympics and she has a medal. She's been to the World Championships and she has three medals, including gold with the team, but she has never been to a Pan American Games. Well, come the end of the day, Jordan Childs might well find herself a Pan American Games medalist as well. She didn't really start elite gymnastics training in earnest until rather late this summer, but she's found her stride. 14.1, the score for Jordan Childs on the uneven bars. 11.1, meanwhile, for Lucila Estarli of Argentina. We have had a long wait to see the work of Zoe Miller on the uneven bars. Here it is, a showcase of in-bar stalders and real fluidity of swing. One of the best things about her work on uneven bars is how effortless she makes all of this look. Dismount, double layout, and she's flying. Zoe Miller of the United States finishing off a tremendous day for the defending Pan American Games champions. The statistics for this team at this event are truly mind-boggling. In all the editions of women's gymnastics at the Pan American Games, the U.S. has finished without gold only twice. The last time coming in 1999. Fabulous Stalder and Kachev. The downy skill, if memory serves, followed by a pack salto, and this, the cherry on top of the cake, double layout and a really good landing. 14.766 for Zoe Miller. She will lead the qualification on uneven bars. And the difficulty of that routine, 6.4. Photo time for the USA and Argentina. How lovely to see gymnasts enjoying themselves and having fun at the highest levels of the sport. Classified results in the team competition after two of three subdivisions of the women's team final at the 2023 Pan American Games. The United States leading the way by nearly 15 points over Mexico, Colombia, Argentina, the other team in the subdivision, finishing in fourth place so far. Panama is in fifth. And as the USA captures the moment, the gymnasts will prepare to march out of the arena. Four teams still to perform, including Brazil, in the next subdivision.
Judges.